Hi everyone, and welcome to my session, Build and Deploy PyTorch Models with Azure Machine Learning. My name is Henk Boelman, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. I have a website, henkboelman.com, where you can find all the articles, source codes, and everything I'm going to show you in this presentation. And of course, you can follow me on Twitter. So what are we going to talk about this coming 45 minutes? We're going to talk about machine learning on Azure, and we are going to build a Simpsons classification model using PyTorch and Azure Machine Learning. So first, let's dive into what machine learning on Azure actually is. Like, what kind of services do we have? So the first and easiest layer to get started with machine learning on Azure is using our cognitive services. Here we train our models. Like, we train our custom vision model, our computer vision model, our language models, and expose them to you through an API. So if you want to use computer vision in your application, you just have to call an API. But sometimes that is not enough, and you want to train your own models for your, on your own specific data. And you can train with any framework on our cloud. We have a lot of services that will make it a lot easier for you. Like, we have Azure Databricks, there's Azure Machine Learning, there are machine learning virtual machines, and we supply you with a lot of compute, CPUs, GPUs, whatever you need. And we can help you deploy it in the cloud, on the edge, but we can also give you the model so you can run it on-prem. So, quick introduction about cognitive services. Cognitive services are pre-trained models in the cloud and on the edge. And they're divided in four categories. There is vision, speech, language, and knowledge. So vision, to make your application see. Speech, to make your application talk and listen to you. Language, to understand what is being spoken. And knowledge, if you want to give your application a brain. But today, we're not going to talk about cognitive services. We're going to talk about how we can train our own models in the PyTorch framework. So we have to level up a little bit. So first, what is Azure Machine Learning Studio or Machine Learning Workspace, or in short, Azure Machine Learning? This is a fully managed cloud service that enables us to build, deploy, and share models with each other. So we can work as a team to create our models and run them in production. And today we're going to answer the question, is it Marge, Homer, Bart, or Lisa on the image? So it is going to be a classification model. For that, we're going to use my Simpsons Lego dataset. It is available on my GitHub. So you can download it and redo this all at home. So which tools are we going to use to do this? So we're going to use Azure Machine Learning. We're going to use PyTorch, and we're going to use a GPU-enabled compute cluster. And finally, we will deploy our model into the cloud. Let's have a look at a common scenario, like how you would work together using this service. So typically, there would be a data scientist that will craft a model, use Azure Machine Learning service to train the model, and then register that model into model management. From model management, a developer can pick that model up and build software around it and use build pipelines in Azure DevOps or GitOps to wrap it up in a container or maybe in any other solution where you need a model. And then finally, operations can pick that piece of software up and deploy it into an Azure Kubernetes service or an Azure web app or wherever you want your software to be deployed. Then the client can actually send images to an API that will pick up the image, run it through the model, and give back the result. So let's dive in a little bit deeper in what Azure Machine Learning Service actually is. So it is not just one thing. It is a set of cloud services that work together. And they can be controlled by the Python SDK or an Azure CLI. And that enables us to prepare and manage our data, to build and train our models and manage our models, and finally pick that model up and deploy it. And to do that, we're going to three stages. first, we have to set up our environment. Then we have to start experimenting with our model and our data. And then finally, we deploy it into production or in dev test scenario or a load balance scenario, whatever we need. So let's start with preparing our environment. You can do that in multiple ways. You can use the Azure portal. You can use an ARM template. You can use the Azure Machine Learning plugin in Visual Studio Code. You can use the Python SDK, or you can use the Azure CLI. So my preferred way is always something you can redo. So you would use the Python SDK or the Azure CLI to do that and check in those comments into a GitHub repository or any other repository, but mark them down so you can actually recreate your environment very easily. In Python, you say you install your Python package, start up a notebook, and then you say workspace, create, give it a name, point to your subscription ID, point it to a research group, and specify your location. And by choosing your location is already a very important step in setting this workspace up for you. Because later on, you're going to choose compute, and not every type of compute is available in every region. So you have to first look, hey, are these NC6 machines, these GPU-enabled machines, available in the region where I'm going to deploy my workspace? If no, choose another region. So West Europe is mostly a region where all the things you want are available. So you say workspace create, you create your workspace, takes around 3 to 5 minutes, and then you can write out a configuration file. This configuration file, you can check in to your GitHub repository, and then everyone else can say workspace from config. So pop up an authentication window so you can connect to Azure. And then if you have the appropriate access to this resource, you will connect to that workspace. So it's very easy to share this configuration with each other. So now that you have your workspace, you can go to the Azure portal. And you see that it lives outside of the Azure portal in ml.azure.com. So it is a separate interface. So you have a little bit more space. And on the left, you have all your options. So you have, for instance, dataset, experiments. So let's zoom into these ones. First, we have datasets. This is the place where you can find back all your registered datasets. We will create one in the demo containing all the Simpson images, and you can version these datasets here, so you can always see which images were used in which training run, which led to which model. Then there are experiments. Under experiments, you keep track of your training runs. So every time you submit a job that will execute a training script, it will give you metrics, it will give you a model, and everything is logged under these experiments. Then when your job is done, you can choose to register your model under models. And I always call this like kind of the NuGet repository for models, because you register a model, it gets a version number, and everyone else can connect to that model management and pick out the model. I say, hey, I want to have my PyTorch model version 5, the Simpsons model version 5, give it to me. Then there are endpoints. There are multiple types of endpoints. There are real-time endpoints. Here you find your deployed models. You can deploy your model in a managed endpoint, in an AKS service, in an Azure Container instance. You will all find the endpoints and configuration and how you can use them back there. And then there are pipeline endpoints. We're not going to dive into pipelines in this presentation, but pipelines are steps that together form a workflow. So there is a step that will do the data prep. There is a step that will do the training. There is a step that will register your model. You can group these ones together and publish a pipeline. And those pipelines can be kicked off by calling a REST endpoint. Then there is compute. Here you can manage all your compute, like your clusters for training, your inference clusters, your notebook compute. Everything is managed there. And under data stores, you can manage the connections to your data. So if you want to connect to a blob storage where your data is, you register that data store here. And in your code, you can just use connect to DataStore Hank. You don't need to have your credentials in your code anymore, because that is all managed in the Azure Machine Learning workspace. So let's create some compute. Here we say Azure Machine Learning Compute. This is your provisioning configuration. I want a virtual machine size standard NC6. This is the cheapest virtual machine that has a GPU in it that is optimized for compute. So standard N, NVIDIA C Compute 6. And I say minimum node is 1, maximum node is 6. So this means that my cluster can scale up between 1 and 6 virtual machines, and there is always one up and running. This means I will be built constantly. If I put 0 there, minimum node 0, it will automatically shut down if there is nothing to do after like 30 seconds or 3 minutes, whatever you give in. Finally, I say compute target, create my Azure Machine Learning Compute. It will start building the cluster for me. Depending on your virtual machine size, this takes around 10 minutes to do and start up your first node. Then finally, we need to attach storage. Now by default, you get a default storage. This is a blob storage that is in the same resource group. But maybe you already have a data store with all your data, and if you have gigabytes and gigabytes of data, you don't want to transfer it between data stores. So you can also register an already known Azure Blob container. And this doesn't even have to be in the same subscription. As long as you give the account name and the account key, you can connect to it. So let's take a look in a real life Azure Machine Learning workspace, in my Azure Machine Learning workspace called Cybertron. Let me zoom in a little bit. I hope it is readable. So here on the left side, we have all the things in the workshop. Here we have the data sets, we have our models, we have our endpoints, we have our compute. So let's dive in our compute first. So here we have compute instances, compute clusters, and inference clusters, and attached computes. So compute instances are used to run your Jupyter notebooks on. We will dive into the notebooks a little bit later, but here you can create that compute and you can start and stop them from here. My compute clusters I use to train my models. See, I've one node up and running. I can zoom into this cluster when it is created. And here you see the standard NC6 is 6 cores, 56 gigabytes of RAM, some disk. And here is the thing that it is all about. It is a one-time Tesla K80 GPU Linux dedicated for me. And my configuration is minimum number of nodes is 1, so always be built for it. Maximum is 4, so you can scale up to 4 jobs concurrently, and it scales down after 1800 seconds. Next, let's take a look at what shall we pick? Datasets. Let's dive into here first. Here we see our data store datasets. So we're using the Lego Simpsons dataset. It's already here. I have 3 versions of it. We can see how we can consume it, and we can explore this dataset. Now indexing, and here we see all the images in it. And a lot. And here we see the images that we're going to use to train our model. So let's start a notebook. So this is my folder with all my files I have a lot. And here's my Jupyter notebook. Because it is all a little bit small, I'm going to go into focus mode so we can see the notebook a little bit better. If it is not readable, just drop a message in the chat and I will see it. So I've created this Jupyter notebook. We see it is running on CliffJumper. It is running, we're using a Python 3 kernel. Here I can stop it, start it. And Jupyter notebooks are really cool because I can put in some code, hit the play button, and it will execute my code. And it will share states between all the cells. I can add some no more code, I can add some markdown. So it is really good for prototyping and today and doing this kind of programming. So let's start with importing all the dependencies. I like to put it all in one cell on top. but you can of course put it also in every cell where you need the dependency. So let's run this cell, see what it does. So I'm saying workspace from config. And here we print out the workspace name, Cybertron. So I'm going to connect to my compute target, Optimus Prime. That's the compute target we just took a look at with the Tesla CPU, compute target, Optimus Prime. We're going to use our default data store, and we're going to connect to the experiment that groups everything together, Simpsons, PyTorch. So it all starts with data. So first I'm going to download the data set. Then I'm going to unzip my data set. This is still locally on the CliffJumper instance. I unzip it, and then I'm going to upload everything to my Azure Machine Learning data store. Then I'm going to create a data set from it by saying, here are all my images, and create a data set from these files. And then register this data set as LEGO Simpsons V3. And create a new version if it is needed. So I've already done this because nobody wants to see me upload 540 images. So if you want to reuse the data set, you can just say data set get by name, and then it will automatically get for you the latest version of this data set. So we can preview the data set. We loop through the training directory where all the downloaded images are. And we put a nice frame around it, and here we see the whole family. So we see we're going to train 10 classes of images. So next up is training our model. So let's recap a little bit. So we've created a workspace, we created some compute, and we set up a storage and created a data set. So now it is actually time to start experimenting with our model and our data. So the first thing we need to do is create an experiment. So we have the experiment and we've connected to it. Then we need the actual file that will do the training for us. So here you see a sample file, but I've taken a sample file from the PyTorch website and I've run that as is. We will dive into that a bit later. Then we need to create a Scriptron configuration. And here is where the thing starts. So the training file has to run into an environment, and we are the ones that can configure that environment, because for every model you need something different. So there are two ways of doing that. You can pick up a curated environment, that is an environment that is managed by Microsoft. You can just pick it up, you say, I want curated environment Azure Machine Learning PyTorch version 1.6 GPU enabled, and you just pick out that environment. And with environment, basically, I mean, pick up that container where my training script is going to run in. I say clone, and I'll have that environment. Or I can create a new environment. So I can create a new environment based on a plain image and install pip packages and conda packages in it. I will choose now an Azure Machine Learning PyTorch 1.6 environment, because that one has all the things I need. So when we have our environment, when we have our training script, and we have our data, now we can configure how our script has to run. And it is called a script run configuration. So my script takes incoming arguments. It needs to know where the data is and how many training runs it has to do. It needs to know where the training script on my local device actually is, on which compute target it has to run, and which environment it has to run. So I say config, create a new script run config. Here is the project folder, here are my training scripts. This is the actual training script you have to call, compute target, Optimus Prime, the PyTorch environment we've created in the previous step, and parse these incoming arguments so my script actually knows what to do. Then when we have that estimator or script run configuration, we have to submit that to our cluster, to the experiment. Then it will start up, build the container, deploy the container in our cluster, and start streaming the output back. And we can view that output by the widget, by run details, give the run object, and it will show us. And then we will see how our accuracy is going, how our training loss is going, how long it is actually taking to train it, and we can follow it real time. So let's actually train our model here. So first of all, let's start with the training script. This training script is an example from the PyTorch website. So you can just go there and download that classification. It's a default classification example using transfer learning. So only thing we do is write out this file of this cell as training scripts train.py. We start with importing our dependencies, and I've added a few things to this script. I added a reference to these two packages so I could parse incoming arguments and that I can connect to my Azure Machine Learning environment and get a context where it is running in. So I get the context, parse my incoming arguments, put them in normal variables here, and then I start with preparing my data set. I resize everything, I flip the color things, load the data set, train the model. We loop to the number of training rounds, we print that to the console, and here I'm logging my loss and accuracy to Azure Machine Learning. By calling this method and putting here every time the same name and entering floats, it automatically starts drawing graphs for the loss and the accuracy. We will see that when we are training. And finally, I write a save my model in the outputs folder and save my labels in the outputs folder. Because everything you save in the outputs folder will be copied back to your experiment. Because this is running in a Docker container on my cluster, and my cluster will shut down. If it is not copied back to my experiment, then the model is like gone. So you want to make sure at the end of the run, you actually save your outputs. So next up is defining the environment. So I'm using a curated environment, Azure ML, PyTorch 1.6. You can find all the types of environments here. Can look at it if you want. PyTorch 1.7, it's there. So I get the environment and clone it. And then it is time to configure my script run. Everything is in the project folder, train.py, my compute target, PyTorch environment, and our incoming arguments. We run that, we submit it to our cluster, and then we ask for the details. Our compute cluster is already up and running, so it should start really fast. So we will see that soon. It will start. So it is deployed, it is starting. And here we can see, in a while, the log files. So first, we'll see that it is starting up our Azure Container Registry, copying Azure Container Registry. Deploying it, and then it will start in a bit with executing my train.py. Yeah, let's wait for that. Then we can see the graph starting, which is really cool. So this is the log file, driver.log. We can actually see what your training script is generating. We see we're downloading the base model. And here we see the training round one, the training and the accuracy validation loss. And here we see this is what the log function is actually doing for us. And here all the accuracy, and this graph is almost real time. So that's pretty cool. So let's go back to the presentation and zoom in what is actually happening when you're doing this, because there are a lot of moving parts when you say submit. So I'm running in my Azure notebook. So at the moment I said submit my job, it snapshotted everything in my folder, training scripts and everything else that is in that folder, and I started copying it over to the experiment. Then it created a Docker file, a Docker image, based on my environment. So either it picked a curated environment or started building my Docker image and put it in my Azure Container Registry. Then I deployed that Docker container to the compute target, so deploy that, and it snapshots it to compute. Then it mounted the data store or the data set. So from the script can access the data in a virtual directory, so slash. So that is really easy. And then it launched the training script. While it was running, it streamed all the outputs back to the experiment. So all the logging goes back to the experiment. And then because I had that widget installed, I can actually connect to the experiment and get all the data. And finally, when the script is done, just before it shuts down, it copies over everything from the output folder back to the experiment. So when that is done, our model is in the output of the experiment. So, but I want to have it in model management so everyone else can use it. I want to publish my model. So I say run, register my model, I give it a name and tell it where it can find it. In this case, it is in the directory outputs. So let's see if our model is done training. Yeah, it is done. It is here at around 15. Here we see it is completed. It took 2.5 minutes. And so far, so good. No errors. So that is perfect. So let's, before we register the model, so let's say here AI conf. So let's register it and then see what actually happened. So the experiment, we run the experiment Simpsons PyTorch, and the latest run was 47. So we can click on that. And here we see everything we need to know about that run. You see what the duration, the compute duration, basically the same at this for this one. Which compute target was used, which training script, who did it. And this is quite important. Here we see the input data set. We can click on that and go actually to the data set and explore it. So that is handy. Under metrics, we can see all the graphs we have generated. So we can compare different runs. Under any shelter, under outputs and logs, you'll find all the logging. This one was the one that we were real-time following. And they're also here again. And they're also in the output folder. There are the labels from our Simpson and is the actual model. Yep, snapshot is the training file. That was the only file I had in my training directory here, so we can later on read it. And then there are some monitoring, fairness, and explanations tabs here if you want to implement that. On the models, we've registered the model. You see September, 3:00, with the tag AI-conf. We can click on the models, see here which framework was used, which experiment is generated, and which run it is generated. So now we can go back from the model to the run to the data set. We can find on the versions, other versions of this model. So see, I've already done this a lot over the past year. We'll see the artifacts here, so we can take a peek. And here we can see in which endpoints it is deployed. So that will be the next step, that we will actually deploy it into an endpoint so we can see and test it from there. Then we have some explanations and data sets which we didn't link to it. Okay. So far we have done creating an experiment. We had a training file. We created a script on config, the configuration how our script had to run in. We submitted that to our cluster and then we registered the model. So now everyone can connect to our Azure Machine Learning workspace and pick out the model for us. So the step three, the final step, is how are we actually going to deploy this as an API in production? So Azure Machine Learning can help us with that too. To do that, we need three things. we need a model. We need a file that loads in the model and runs data through it. And we need a file that will specify how our environment has to look, which packages need to be installed to actually run the model. So those three combined, we will wrap up and we will create a Docker image for it. And that Docker image we can deploy later on to an Azure Container instance or to an AKS, so Azure Kubernetes Service. So that the score.py, that is the file where it will load in the model and runs the data through the model, needs to have two methods. There is an init method that will get our model and load the model. And then there is a method that will run the data through our model, because loading a model can take time and we don't want to do that on every request. Then there is an environment file that will specify which packages needs to be installed in this environment. We have to combine those three things in an inference config. So we say the runtime is Python, your script is score.py, and this is the environment file. So now we have that inference configuration. So how does it have to work? We can start deploying that using a deployment configuration. We can deploy three methods. At this time, we can use an Azure Container instance. We can use to an Azure Kubernetes service that is linked to it, not any. You have to actually link it, and or a managed endpoint. So the easiest and fastest way is to deploy it to an Azure Container instance, which is just two lines of code. So we have to make another configuration, an Azure Container instance config, where we just have to specify how many CPU cores you have to use and how many gigabytes of memory. So one core, 2 gigabytes of memory is more than enough for my model. Then I say model, deploy it, give it a name, use this model, this inference config, and the deployment config. Then wait 5 minutes and your API is up and running. Deploying to AKS takes one step more. You have to first connect to your AKS target. And then once you're connected, it takes only like 10 to 30 seconds to deploy. So let's deploy this to an Azure Container instance. We go back to our Jupyter notebook and start with downloading the model. Because first we want to see, before we're going to deploy it, we first want to see if this model is actually working. So we'll deploy it and we'll run it through some code that will load the model, load the labels, and then scores the image, and that makes it pretty for us to look at. And here we see all these images are run through the model, and we see that it is doing quite well on some, a little bit not so good on some others, but it is doing the job. So I'm okay with it and I want to deploy the model. So I'm going to write a scoring script. Init method, we load the model, load the labels, and then run get a JSON file with a URL parameter, download that image to the container, then pre-process it, run it through the model and return the result. So also for this, we need to have an environment. And I can pick out a curated environment, but I want to keep my environment as small as possible with not more packages than necessary. So I'm going to create a clean environment, call it Simpsons Inference, and install just these 4 packages in it. Azure Machine Learning defaults, you need always to have the Torch and Torch Vision and this very specific version of Pillow. So I'm creating that. Okay. And then I'm going to create the inference config, which combines the scoring script with the environment. I can download and connect to my model. This comment always will get the latest version of the Simpson PyTorch model. So in this case, it is 67. That's the one we've trained. And then we can start deploying it. I will just hit deploy because it will take a little while. So we create a deployment configuration. Say SGA Web Service deployment configuration. CPU cores and model. So I could have written here one and two, but I've saved this preferred resource configuration while I was registering the model. So I skipped over that while doing that. So I'll scroll back up and here we say that I've made a resource configuration. So CPU 1, gigabytes of memory 2. So if my model changes, this script below will automatically picks up the changes and spins up the right environment for me. Deploying it here to an ACI. If that is done, that would have been really, really fast. I don't think that is done. So it is now deploying that. So here we have the deployment there. And we call it the Simpsons Lego classifier. Checking the status. Fun. Okay. So it has deployed our model that is extremely fast. What we do is here we ask the scoring URI. So this is the scoring URI we have now. And we could use Postman to start posting things to that, but we can also use a script I've made that will post images to this URL. So here I have a list of images that is in the container. This is images the model has never seen. We will load this URL, we will loop through it, and we will use this comment to run the data to the model. No, we will use this comment to send the JSON to the endpoint. So the ACI service run URL image name. So now we have sent all this to our endpoint and here we see it is basically giving us the same results. Next, we should now be able to see under models, our 67 model, that it is deployed in our endpoint, the Simpsons PyTorch ACI. We can click on that. We can see here the details when it was created, when it was last updated on. So this is UTC with which model. We can take a look at the deployment logs. So here we see all the posts we have just done. We can also test it from here or see some code from here, how to consume it, and we can test it from here by just saying URL is, let's go back to the notebook. Here were some URLs. Let's test for Krusty endpoints. Test. Okay. Here we type it, we paste it, we say test. And here we see that it's saying Krusty, and let's send bar to it. I think March is lower. It's March, and then we have Homer, so we can send them all. And we'll see it gives us back really fast the prediction. And now this is ready to use in your solutions. You can secure this with an authentication token by just flipping a boolean somewhere when you're deploying it, and you can enable application insights to gather insights from your container. So everything is there for you. So a small recap before we end. We started with preparing and setting up our environment, set up a workspace, have created compute and set up our storage. Then we started experimenting with our model and our data. We created an experiment, trained our model and registered our model. And finally, we created a deployment and deployed the model to an Azure container instance. If you want to do this, all the code, the whole Jupyter Notebook is available on ak.ms/Azure Machine Learning Service AMLS PyTorch. So my name is Henk Boelman. If you want to contact me, you can find me on Twitter, on GitHub, or on my blog. And this would be the time for questions, if there are any.